Welcome to your little yoga practice. Today we'll be taking it slow. We'll be moving slowly. We'll be moving deliberately. We will hold poses for a while. We will see if we can release some tension that has built up in our bodies and just be with what is, to not fight our bodies in any way. We don't cram our bodies into the pose. We use the pose to feel deeper into our body. Let's take a deep breath together. Exhale, relax. Just stay here for a moment. Just notice what is going on in your body right now. Can you be 10% more at ease? Take another deep breath here. Exhale, relax. Good. Be fully present here. For the next 20 or so minutes, just doesn't matter what else is on your to-do list for the day. It doesn't matter what happened before or what will happen after. The past is gone, the future hasn't arrived yet. Let's just be right here. And right here means in your individual beautiful body. And yes, it is a beautiful one. You're alive. We tend to see all the things that don't work in our bodies or that don't work in the way that we would love them to be. But let's work with what we have instead. Let's be grateful for what we have. Let's just love on ourselves. And the more we can open into that, the more our bodies will in turn appreciate us inhabiting them, if you will. So what we need for today's practice, apart from your willingness to put yourself into it, is, depending on your body geometry, maybe something for you to sit on. Right now I'm sitting on this little meditation cushion. It could be either a folded pillow or a rolled blanket, whatever you have available. And then for some poses, it may make it easier if you have a yoga block. It can be replaced by a big book or something else that is a little more stable that can give you support. And maybe a yoga strap. So our body geometries are pretty different. And that means everybody may need different support in different poses. And while in an ideal world, we would find ourselves to be able to simply copy a pose exactly in the way how it is shown, in the real world, we look at what we have, what our body is capable of today, and how we can work with that to get into that feel of the pose more than into the specific shape. So that means we focus on lengthening certain body parts. Sometimes we focus on finding a twist in certain body parts. And sometimes that means bending in a certain way. But it's more about the feeling inside than about the shape that we see from the outside. So be gracious with yourself, be gentle and kind with yourself, especially in this practice. Let's take one more deep inhale here. Raise your arms over your head. Bring your hands together and lower your hands to your heart. We'll open the clasp with one arm together. Inhale for arm. Join me if you like. Of that in your body and how maybe it brings you home just a little more. And then raise your arms again, interlace your fingers, and then turn the palms up towards the ceiling. Now, if you can straighten your elbows, great. If not, great too. What you want to focus on is to reach those palms up towards the ceiling as much as possible, and then bringing your shoulders away from your ears again. So we don't want those shoulders scrunched up. There's a lot of space in between your shoulders and your ears. And then keep breathing deep here. And check if you can engage your abs such that you don't fall into a banana back. So the engaged abs are going to make your lower back happy, keep it happy. And the reaching up helps you grow out of the crown of your head. So reach the crown of your head really tall while you reach up those hands. And with the inhale, keep growing upward. And with the exhale, see where you can soften in your body. Give it two more breaths here. And focus on all the sensations that come through your body right now. Maybe your shoulders are already talking to you loud and clear. That's okay, we're almost there. Last inhale. Exhale, release. Shake it out a little. And then take your right hand and bring it over to the left thigh or to the left knee, whatever is in reach. I got short arms, for me it's the thigh. And the right hand can go behind you. It can either go on the floor if it's long enough, or if not, you can place your hand onto your lower back, onto your sacrum, fingers down, such that the twist is supported as well. And then you look to the right, and if available, over your right shoulder. So the twist here comes from the area around your navel, and also from like the area of the rib cage. There is only little in the neck. The neck is just an extension of the twist. It's not what makes the twist twisty. So be easy on your neck. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come back to center. And then we'll take the hand to the left side. Sorry, your other hand, your left hand, and hand on the lower back or on the floor behind you. Inhale, sit tall, exhale, twist. And again, engage your obliques to help you come a little deeper into that twist. Your hips stay in place, they don't move. And the gaze can follow over the shoulder as far as that is available to you. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come back to center. Good. Interlace your fingers behind your head. With an inhale, open your heart wide, pull those elbows back a tad, see how wide you can open that heart space. Keep your lower abs engaged so you don't make a hollow back. You can raise your gaze if that feels okay for your neck. One more deep inhale here. How much can you expand that rib cage? And then gentle exhale. Bring those elbows forward. And then depending on how much your neck likes this, you can just let the weight of your arms gently pull down the head. If it gets too much, just lift your arms. Good. With your next inhale, sit back up. let go of those fingers. If you were sitting on a cushion or a block, then maybe you want to take it out for the next one because we're going to fold forward. I'll take it out such that I don't face plant. But maybe it still feels good for you depending on how open your hips are. So inhale, sit up tall. Exhale, walk those fingertips forward. So here you want to make sure that you're not rounding your lower back. We want to reach forward with a long lower back. So you want to reach your heart instead of curling. I'll show you from the side. So here you see my back is straight, and then I walk my fingertips forward. Lower back stays really nice and long, so we're not going here. If this is all you can do with a straight spine, you stay right here. This is a good place to be. And just work on the hips here. This is what we want to feel. You may feel it here on the adductors, or you might feel it on the outside of your hips, and either one is good. Just make sure you keep reaching your heart. And if you're super flexible, you can walk way further out. Maybe you want to bring your elbows down. Maybe you can even rest your head on the floor. I'm not there today. And if you are closer to the ground, but not all the way to the ground, you can use a block. Maybe that's a more comfortable pose for you to hold your stretch. Give it two more breaths here. Exhale, come back up. And then from here, we're going to come into tabletop position. So place your hands on the mats, knees go underneath your hips, hands go underneath your shoulders, so that you're like a little box. And then with your inhale, let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward, reach the tailbone up. Exhale, cat, round everything. Tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, reach your heart forward, belly sinks down. Exhale, round. Inhale, heart reaches forward. Exhale, round. Inhale, one more time, heart reaches forward. Exhale, round. With your next inhale, come back to neutral back position and sit back into child's pose. Reach your arms really long out here. And then your forehead can rest on the floor if that is available to you. If that is not available, you can use a block and have your forehead on the block. So, say if your hips are up here, then head to the floor might feel way out of reach. You can take your block the other way. You could even put a block here behind, if that helps, and put something underneath your forehead. For most people that I've seen in practice, the block underneath the forehead here is better than underneath there, because you're going to sink down over time as you become a little more open while holding the pose. So just make sure you find a version that is okay for you to stay in for a little bit. Sooner or later it's going to become a little intense here in the hips. If you have tummy stuff going on, or lower back stuff, it may feel nice to have your knees further apart. So I'll show you in the diagonal so you can see it better. You can take your knees a little further apart. Big toes touch. And then you just come down here in the same way. You can also use the block in this version. Rest your forehead on the block. And your belly has more space to expand here in between. It's also great if you're pregnant. And then you can just relax here.
the next inhale, slowly roll up.
You come to sit on your heels. We'll open up the soles of our feet a little bit. So we'll lift your bum off your heels and then tuck your toes under and then come back down to sit on your heels. And within probably the first 5 to 10 seconds, unless you have really open feet, you're going to start feeling this quite a bit. So just stay with it. Be gentle with yourself here. Be kind. If it gets excruciating, you can always lean forward and take weight out of the pose. You can also use a block here if it's too much. So both of that is available to you. Yogi's choice. You always want to challenge yourself a little bit. You don't want to torture yourself. Never ever. Very good. Just feel a little deeper into what's going on. And keep your ankles under your hips. Don't let them come out sideways. Last breath here. Inhale, come forward onto fingertips, untuck those toes, lay them flat on the ground, wiggle them to make sure all 10 are still there, and then you can lean back and come into a counter stretch. Your knees may come off the floor here, unless you're really wide open in your quads and hips maybe. And you feel a stretch in the front of your ankles and in the front of your foot. One more breath here. Exhale, come back to center. And we'll come back on our knees and we'll step forward with the right foot and we'll come into a low lunge. And so here, depending on how flexible your body is today, maybe you want to grab those blocks. You want to make sure that you feel a stretch in the front of your left hip. So if you're standing here very boxy, you're not going to feel a stretch, and you just wiggle that right foot forward until you feel a stretch in this part here. Hands can go on the block or they can go on the mat. And then we'll hold here for a couple of breaths. Give it one more breath here. And then with the exhale, we're slightly going to change this pose. We're going to wiggle that right foot a little more to the side, and we'll come into lizard pose. So now we have both hands on the inside of the foot, and this gives you more room to let those hips sink. Maybe you're still on your blocks up here, perfectly fine. You just stay right here and you just feel a slight change in how that hip opens to the right. Maybe this version allows you to come further down, so maybe you can come onto your forearms. And if you can come down, you still want to be reaching your heart forward. So it's not about, can I get down? It's still about reaching forward and just letting that hip sink down further. And staying here is perfectly fine. No need to go down. You can still feel a lot of additional stretch here in this hip opener. One more inhale. Exhale, slowly start straightening the front leg and shift your hips and your weight back. You want to pull those toes up in the front. You can wiggle the foot back towards the middle. And we're in half Hanuman pose. So half splits. Depending on how your knee feels here, maybe you want to pad it a little extra. And then you just keep reaching the hip backwards and keep reaching your heart towards the big toe here. And you also want to make sure you have a long lower back here. So mine is not completely straight, which is fine,
but I don't want to be rounding it like this in order to reach more forward. You can bend that front knee if it's getting too rough back here. You want to work towards straightening, but like I said, you just want to have a little bit of a challenge, not any pain going on in there. And you can use your blocks on either side to prop you up to the right height for you. Two more breaths here. Good, and then shift your weight back forward so that you can step that right foot back, and we'll bring the left foot forward. So first we're going to come into the low lunge. So wiggle the foot forward until you can let those hips sink to a degree where you can feel a stretch on that right hip front. And then from here we're just going to be reaching the heart, fingertips on the floor, or hands on blocks, or fingertips on blocks, whatever is the right level for you here. And keep breathing deep. One more deep breath here. Good, and then we'll go into the variation. We'll go into lizard. So wiggle that front left leg out a little bit so that both of your hands can go on the inside of that leg. And then you can either just stay here, or your hands could still be on blocks up here on whichever height is good for you today. Or you can come down on your forearms. So whatever is in reach, and for either variant, keep reaching that heart forward. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, slowly start straightening the front leg and shift your weight backwards. You can wiggle that foot towards center a bit. And then pull the toes back towards your face. Again, block can be close depending on which height you want to work from. And if for some reason this is too much on the knee that's on the mat, if you cannot pad it enough, then you can always sit back down and do that same stretch seated. So for some people, this is the more challenging version for the knee. For other people, the lifted version is more challenging on the knee. So you pick yours. Last inhale here. Gently come forward such that you can take that leg back. And then we'll come into frog pose. So for frog pose, you want to take your knees really wide and your feet are going to be in line with your knees. And the toes are going to be pointing outward. So you want to make sure that you're padded enough here, because otherwise this may get intense for the inside of your knees. And maybe you want to have some kind of bolster or pillow to lay on, because then we'll come down onto our forearms. And the idea is to let your knees become as wide as possible and let your hips sink to the floor. Now, depending on how flexible you are, this can become pretty intense, which is why it's nice if you can have some kind of bolster to take part of your body weight, because then it's easier to hang out here. So you pick whatever is the right prop for you to assist you in this pose. I'm very grateful for my meditation cushion today, because my right shoulder is not very happy, and therefore it's good to take some of the body weight in that pose via the pillow. And then with every exhale, see where you can still soften a bit in your body. two more breaths here. Your next inhale, slowly come back out of the pose. And bring your knees gently together. Sit back on your heels. Come into a little counter pose. So you can hold your knees and then round your back, tuck your chin and gently round your back. Here, we're gonna take the left leg and step it over the right leg. So we're gonna sit on the right side. You got two versions here to go into Matsyendasana, twisted seat. So you can either keep that lower leg bent, or if that doesn't feel great because it's too much, you can straighten out that bottom leg. Either way, the top leg is just gonna step over and it's gonna be somewhere from next to your knee to mid-thigh, depending on what your hip availability or your range of motion in the hip allows you to do. And then we can wrap that other arm around the knee and look over that shoulder. Come into another twist here. And again, with every inhale, sit a little bit taller, and with every exhale, twist just a little deeper. Two more inhales here. Inhale, come back to center, and we'll do the other side. So whichever version you chose for the leg was good. Do the same on this one. And then wrap the arm, sit up nice and tall. Other hand goes right behind you. And then twist from your abs. Keep your shoulders far away from your ears. Keep both sitting bones on the ground. And keep the bottom leg active. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come back to center. And then I'm going to slowly make our way down. We'll come into a figure four in a seated version first. So we cross the ankle over the other knee, and then you find the right distance for you. If this is a good stretch, make sure you don't slouch here, but reach your heart forward and engage your abs and have a straight lower back, and then you can just keep reaching your heart forward so you get closer to that leg. That's going to intensify it. If it's not intense enough, get that foot closer to you. Reach up. Two more breaths here. Down, and then we'll switch legs and do the other side. So ankle up on the foot, reach the heart forward. If it's not enough, get that foot closer to the booty and keep reaching. And then notice what thoughts are going on in your mind right now. Are you still here in the middle of the practice? Are you being kind to yourself in your thoughts? And then just come back to your breath. Last breath here. Exhale, slowly release that foot, and we're gonna roll down.
from here, we're just gonna do one back bend. I'm gonna come into bridge pose. So you lift your hips up and you press your arms into the mat. Your heels kind of drag back towards you, so your hamstrings are engaged. And then you want to have space for your neck so it doesn't get too much compression. So slightly press the back of your head into the floor as well. If you would like a little more, you can interlace fingers if that's available to you and walk your arms closer together so that you get more of a heart opener here. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come down. Good. Move those knees from left to right a bit. Did you hear my back crack? Okay. So, last one, we're gonna do a very gentle inversion. So you have several ways of doing that. You can take your block if you have one. We're just gonna do legs up. You can place that underneath your sacrum and lift your legs. If you like that idea but you don't have a block or a book, you can turn towards the wall and just place those legs up against the wall, and that's going to hold them in place instead. Or if you get neither one but you got a block, then you can use a strap to keep those feet in place. And so I said no block but this. So you get your strap in pretty long. Longer. So that it can go behind your head. And so you want it at a length where it doesn't strain your neck, and we just keep that balance a bit. So pick your favorite out of those three versions. It can be with the strap, it can be with the block under your hips, or it can be your legs up against the wall. I like the version with the strap because it reminds me that everything is an act of balance, and whenever we move something in a system, then that's going to lead to changes in other places. So every slight movement of my head, I can feel how that moves my feet and the other way around. Three more breaths here. And gently come out of whichever version you chose for yourself. And for our final resting pose, we'll come into a slight heart opener, into a supported heart opener. So you can use the block for this one, or you can use a pillow. Either one goes underneath the tips of your shoulder blades. If this is too much of a heart opener, you can also use two pillows or two blocks and put the other one under your head. And then you bring the soles of your feet together and let your knees fall to the outside. So this way, you're perfectly supported. If you want to go deeper, you take out this one. and have a deeper heart opener. And then see where else you can let go here. Two more breaths here. And then gently bring your knees together. You can help those thighs from the sides. And roll off whichever support you laid on. And then straighten out your legs, straighten out your arms. Come into Shavasana. Lay your shoulder blades flat against the mat. Let your eyes roll back into their sockets. Relax into the back of your body. Final resting pose is your integration of the practice. Take just those few moments to let yourself fully absorb the benefits of your practice, so it gets stored into muscle memory, so you come back into the fullness of your being. This beautiful body of yours that supports you all day long. And this is one of the ways how we love it back. Treating it gently, with care, moving it sufficiently, stretching, and being very present with it. Free to stay here for a couple of minutes longer, for as long as your body asks for.